A big part in real-time UNIGINE projects is played by content typically created in digital content creation tools. Various graphic resources, such as textures and geometry, should be appropriately imported in UNIGINE. In this tutorial, you will learn how to import 3D models using your UNIGINE project. UNIGINE supports the most popular 3D data formats and a set of industrial CAD formats available starting with the Engineering SDK edition. FBX is the format supported by most 3D editors, and among geometry, can contain various graphic data. It is recommended to use FBX as an intermediate file format to bring your 3D models to UNIGINE. To ensure that there are no placement and rotation issues, the model has to be exported appropriately. Check out our tutorials on preparing and exporting 3D models from various modeling applications. Let's import an FBX asset. You can do it via the asset browser window that shows everything your project contains. If you've got a different UI layout, you can simply find a said browser, like all the main windows, under the Windows drop-down menu, where you can reset the layout. So, in the asset browser, choose Import New Asset and select the desired files. Another way is to drag files from your file explorer right to asset browser, or if you like, simply copy the source files to the project data subfolder and UNIGINE editor will detect new assets on its own. In case your model consists of several files, for example you have an OBJ file with material libraries or a GOTF and a bin file, it is recommended to import all of them at once to have everything imported correctly. When multiple files are imported, they all will be provided with the last used settings that can be changed later. When you import a single file, the Import Settings window appears. There are plenty of import options available for geometry, materials and textures, animations, joints, cameras, and so on. If you feel the import settings are messed up, simply restore defaults to start from scratch. But start with these general settings. Check import instances if your model contains them. Virtually any modeling software provides support for the concept of instances when several cloned objects refer to the same mesh, such as car wheels or identical buildings and props, avoiding data repetition. Unchecking this flag will import each instance as a separate mesh. Optimize vertex cache is an important option that reorders triangle indices in the most efficient way suitable for runtime. In fact, you can always keep it enabled to ensure the most optimized meshes will get into the final build. Also, keep enabled the correct triangulation flag to avoid triangulation errors of meshes, splines, and patches. It is possible to calculate vertex tangent space required for accurate shading and normal mapping automatically with orientation for the right-handed coordinate system, but it surely can be imported from FBX provided it was included during the export. You can also import materials data, meaning UNIGINE materials will be generated and assigned to meshes according to what's saved in the FBX scene. It will pick up basic material parameters, such as the opacity, diffuse specular, and emission colors and their intensity. UNIGINE can automatically assign materials by names if they are already present in the project. This is what the Take From Assets mode stands for. Be careful with the Overwrite Materials option, as it may replace materials with new ones and you may lose some assets. You should disable it when you already got the materials for the model in your project. If needed, you can use the asset name or specify a custom prefix for materials. You can keep the defaults for now. If materials have textures assigned, import them as well by enabling the corresponding flag. Similarly, only basic textures will be picked up as FBX format isn't fully compatible with the UNIGINE's physically based material workflow. Note that the normal map or bump map has to be converted to a suitable format with normals packed into the RNG channels. The other options section also lets you import cameras and light sources by converting them to UNIGINE and LODs and keeping important parameters. Finally, you can adjust the coordinate system settings if the scene was exported with another basis. UNIGINE assumes Y the front axis and Z the up axis. One unit equals 1 meter, which can be adjusted via these settings. Adjust the scale value to meet the UNIGINE unit size, which is especially useful if you intend to make the mesh part of physical simulations that don't allow using scaled static meshes. As all necessary options are set, we can click Yes to import our model. Now we have an FBX asset with auto-imported materials and textures in our project. Note that in terms of UNIGINE, import implies copying a file to the project folder without linking to the original one. So if you're going to make changes to your model, you should replace the imported file. Let's put things in order a bit and make a folder for textures. You might need to import additional PBR textures, so let's keep everything in one place. Select the FBX and you'll see all import options are in the parameters window, so you can change them anytime and re-import your asset. You can also preview the hierarchy of nodes and surfaces this asset provides when added to the scene. Go straight to the bottom to preview the asset. Use left and right mouse buttons to orbit and zoom in and out. An FBX asset is a container for meshes and animations. If you right-click on it and choose Open or simply double-click on it, you'll see its contents converted into UNIGINE built-in types, called runtime assets. You can also preview the contents by expanding the container in the tree view of the asset browser provided you have Show Assets toggled on. Here we have all meshes. As you can see, there are no duplicates as the Import Instances flag is enabled. All these meshes provide a static mesh object when added to the world. Drag the asset to the viewport to add the whole hierarchy of meshes to the scene at once. A dummy node is created as a parent for the hierarchy of your model, represented by static meshes. Here it is, and the World Nodes window. Each mesh has surfaces corresponding to the parts of the imported model with different materials assigned. They are also named after the materials. After importing geometry, we can set up materials that were created for the surfaces. UNIGINE's material system provides two primary pipelines for meshes. Using the default physically based mesh base material with the strict set of shaders, parameters, and textures that cannot be modified, and materials graphs, the system enabling you to build custom materials using the visual node editor. The base materials mode import option was set to inherited material graphs, which means the editor tried to find the most appropriate material graph as the base material and generated automatically two missing ones based on their parameters. You can see the obtained hierarchy of materials in the materials window. Two auto-generated base material graphs hold all the materials from the FBX. If you import another FBX with the same base materials mode, these material graphs will be used as base materials automatically if their set of settings is suitable. Let's delete these materials for now. The other mode is unique material graphs and it is pretty straightforward. Let's uncheck import texture. We already have them, and click re-import to apply changes. Each material will be converted to a separate material graph. You will have to implement each material separately. The latter option is inherited mesh base. Select it and you'll get your materials inherited from mesh base. This PBR material provides plenty of rendering features and is ready to use. Use it if you have a set of prepared textures for a supported workflow. Metalness, BBR, and a legacy specular. This mode looks up materials in the project by name and assigns them to surfaces if found anything. Let's stick with the first option here. Let's give a proper naming to the material graphs and implement a simple PBR material based on what we have in our textures. However, this is the subject of another tutorial series. Here, we simply define several PBR textures in the material. You can find an example of a simple PBR material in the art sample suite. Now we can adjust necessary options and assign imported textures by simply dragging them to the corresponding fields in the parameters window. So our model looks much better now, but only for close-ups for now. The polygon count is excessive when the model is seen from afar. UNIGINE provides automatic generation of several levels of detail for all meshes within the FBX. Simply specify the number of LODs, set the desired poly count in percent and visibility and fade distances for each one. Pay attention to normals adjustment. You can choose to recalculate normals by angle between adjacent polygons to smooth in polygons automatically and get rid of possible shading issues. The normals preserve value as the intensity of impact of original normals on the generated topology. Using these settings, you can fine-tune the result. Click re-import And now we've got a model with several levels of detail. Each static mesh now has new surfaces with reduced poly count that are visible only at specified distances, keeping the reasonable number of polygons at any moment. Automatic simplification works best with soft edges as hard ones define the main shape of the mesh. Check out the dedicated tutorial for more details on automatic generation of LODs. You can also prepare your own LODs in your modeling software, having them named with certain postfixes. You can choose to combine by postfixes option to automatically organize the levels of detail. In addition to the familiar distance parameters, specify the name postfix for each LOD, and as the result, the LODs become separate surfaces of each static mesh with predefined visibility distances. Per-surface rendering settings provide enough room for optimization purposes. When importing static meshes intended to be light-mapped, such as premises and props, refer to the corresponding section of the import settings. Here, you should select the UV channel to be used for light-maps and the light-map target resolution. You can enable automatic UV unwrapping for the desired channels to get a decent non-overlapping layout if needed. These settings are also available per surface. Follow the tutorial on light mapping for more details on the subject. Importing the animated skinned mesh is also simple. Enable the Import Animations option and they will be included, provided the FBX scene contains skeletal animation data. Note the limits. The maximum supported number of bones per each surface is 128, and no more than 4 bones should affect a vertex. If your scene contains morph targets, also known as blend shapes, you can import them too by enabling the corresponding flag. You can also set the desired frame rate in the corresponding field below. The import bones without skin flag enables you to decide if you want to import bones that are not attached to the skeleton and only needed for the bone hierarchy. Create transform bones for joints simply adds auxiliary control objects that help you use position of each bone. Joints reorientation brings a massive help when it is needed to control the skinned mesh via code. It reorients joints so their forward axis corresponds to the one of the mesh. This simplifies the logic and work with the skinned mesh a lot. The last feature is forced looping of animations. Enable it and choose the number of frames during which starting and ending keyframes will be blended, making the animation smoother. So we click OK and place our model on the scene. Now, if you open the content of the imported model, you'll find a mesh and its animation data. Here we have only one clip. Animated models are represented by skinned mesh objects in UNIGINE. In its parameters, you can see the mesh and animation clip assigned. To preview it, enable playback. Don't forget to enable animation globally using the play pause control. In the bones section, you'll find the hierarchy of bones and the set of settings enabling you to control bones manually by binding them to control nodes. For each joint, a transform bone, the object retrieving bone transformation was created, so you can simply attach an object or an effect to a bone by making it child to the desired transform bone. For example, you can attach a particle-driven rotor wash effect to each blade and get particle emitters positioned exactly where the rotors are. UNIGINE allows you to import heavy models too, such as CAD models for example. Let's take a CAD model exported to a FBX file with a tremendous polygon count. Some import settings may be useful here. First of all, skip empty nodes. Complex CAD models may contain an overloaded object hierarchy with lots of empty nodes. Enable this option to ignore nodes that do not contain any useful information. Next, merge similar materials. CAD software often exports plenty of objects with unique materials assigned even if they are identical. Using this option, you can reduce the number of materials in the model. Also, if your input geometry has size exceeding 10 kilometers across, it may jiggle and have various rendering artifacts due to positioning errors. Split by grid enables you to eliminate such issues by splitting the meshes by grid with the specified step. You could also use the repivot to center feature if your source geometry is somehow displaced from its pivot point. In this case, the pivot point for each mesh will be moved to its spatial center. But check it out. The model is fine, however, its hierarchy includes a lot of separate static meshes. We can optimize the imported model via specific import options. First, we can combine all meshes into a single one using the Merge Static Meshes option. Of course, the set of meshes has changed and we have to replace the broken static meshes in the scene with the new ones. Now, a single mesh has become the parent for all the surfaces. We can also merge all the surfaces having the same materials. Now we've got a single mesh with only 8 surfaces. Let's enable the wireframe mode to see all the polygons of our mesh. In addition to polygon geometry, UNIGINE enables you to import models in CAD formats as well. This feature is available starting with the Engineering SDK edition. Such models are parametric and need to be triangulated first. At import, you will be prompted with additional parameters for mesh triangulation. Linear deflection stands for the maximum distance between triangles generated on straight surfaces. Angular deflection limits the maximum angle between adjacent triangles forming curved surfaces. By adjusting these values, you can define the resulting polygon count and the detail level of the generated meshes. As you can see, various 3D models can be imported to your UNIGINE project, including animated ones, and even heavy CAD models. For more information on content import and optimization, please refer to our online documentation.